Welcome to Beyond the Press channel.
Hello.
I'm Lauri.
And I'm Anni.
And today we are going to put our drill sharpening machine back to use. It has been out of use like 3 years.
Or five.
Yeah, the drive belt didn't stay on, but Timo fixed it on the like last week. And now we need just to add new coolant and then we are ready to sharpen some drills. There is this coolant tank over here. And we thought that it's the only one, but then Timo found out that there is inside of the machine secondary tank that is used to like settle all the stuff that comes out of the drills and the stone. And Timo has left that one to dry and I scraped all the shit from there and there was probably like 5 kilograms of that stuff. So now wondered that the coolant didn't come very well through. And now we need to add more coolant and I have already mixed some here. I have to check that it is right concentration. And the grinding machine, it needs special coolant. Not all coolants are good for the grindstones. So if you have machine like this, it's always important to check that your coolant is good to use with grinders. Yep, and I have this device that is used to check how much there is coolant and how much water. So let's stick here. And then you look through this against light. And there is way too much. It's like 14%. Yep, so there is about double of amount of coolant compared to water that we would need. So I go add more water. Yeah, it's probably a bit too much still. I add little bit more water. But I think it doesn't matter that there's a bit too much of the oil and not enough water. Yep, so it should be pretty good now. Let's add it here. I was pouring it on my food. Not very cool.
Disgusting.
Yeah, and it's now full, but when you start the machine, it sucks it and it goes there. And then it fills up this one also. And then we need to add more, so it's good to have a lot of this ready. Yep, so now we are ready to sharpen some drills. And I found this drill. It's in quite bad shape. There is like big chip missing there. So we need to sharpen about maybe 2 millimeters away from the drill to make it good. And that's also not very good. Yep, so first thing is to mount the drill. And it's mounted from here where it's hold on the drilling machine. And then the chuck hold it from here. So let's first put these regular attachment things. And then open that little bit. It's important to have this chuck open enough. Otherwise the drill will push all the jaws out. And then they are hard to get back. There is different sized jaws for small drills and large drills. So now it fits through there. This goes here. This. Yep.
Yeah.
And then we tighten these. This. And then you have to line the drill to know where it's, to know that it's on the right spot for the machine to sharpen it. And here is this tool for that. You put this here and then you should line the this edge here according to those lines. Yeah, I do it out from the camera because I cannot see it here now. Yeah, that's done now. And then I forgot to measure how big the drill is. I need to do that. Yeah, it's a 35 millimeter drill. And this wheel here, you have to set this according to drill size, and here is the chart to how to do that. So you have three different options: hard steel, steel, and bronze slash aluminium. And the steel is good for general use, so we just pick here 35 for the steel, and it's 2A. And then we turn this like below 2, and yeah, there is 2A now. Yeah, like that. And then we can start the machine from here and put the feed on here. But first we have to decide how much we are going to take off. And you can decide it from this knob here. There is slow and fast feed. I think the fast feed is good if you have to take a lot, which is the case now. I think you cannot use the fast feed for small drills, but this is pretty large, so let's put it full. I think we need to take the whole 2 millimeters, so it's here. And then when you switch up the feed, it goes here like mechanic switch. So if you push it forward, then you are going to use the fast, and back you are going to use the slow one. And it's important to test that you are not have the feed on when you start. And now you can like approach like this, but the machine has to spin. So let's switch it spin. Yeah. And I think we have to check the coolant levels. So I open the coolant thing. Yeah. And this is the bad side of the machine, it sprays the coolant all over, so it's not cool to hang here. But let's let it run up for a while and then check if we have enough coolant. And the coolant, even if I like scrape it up the thing really well, there is still some like grinding shit on the coolant, so it doesn't look very well. But it seems that we have enough of the coolant, so we can start the drilling thing. I put this little bit, I think that's too much. There is proper good one. And now I switch this on from here. Yeah, so it spins. And then I approach.
Can I stand here?
Yeah, yeah. And you have to be quite careful, because if you go lot in when the drill is on like this direction, then it can scrape too much. Yeah, we are pretty close now.
Oh no.
Yeah. And then I switch here the fast feed on.
Oh no, sounds bad.
And then just push from here and it starts to do its magic. Yeah, now we are sharpening. And it goes really slowly. It's going to take like 5 minutes to take that 2 millimeters off. Saisi semmonen iso jalka. Tässä on tälle sopiva jalka. Anni,
yep.
What do you like the sound?
Sounds really sad.
Yeah, but I think it's somehow like satisfying machine to use. Because the like broken drill is quite sad. And the drills out of that machine are excellent. And it's also a good machine for the worker. Because there is Not so much of work using the machine and lot of waiting.
Automatic.
Yep, and when the sad sound stops, then you know it's ready. There is no bling like in your microwave oven. And yeah, you can just do this. This and... Yeah, and now is the most exciting part. Did I remember how the machine works? If you don't have right settings, the drill is going to look really odd when you take it out. So let's have a look how we did. At least back in the day, I knew how to use the machine and the drills were really good. They are good as new. Holy shit, that's one fine drill.
Like a new.
Yeah, isn't it shiny and nice? Then you just hammer these out.
Hammer time.
And be careful not to drop your new drill. Yeah, it looks to be really good. I think we are going to test it with lathe, how good well it drills. Yep, so here we have some random steel on the plate. Lathe. And it's one of our old press pieces. So I think it's a bit harder steel than your normal structural steel. But it should be well able to be drilled with this drill. So. Yeah, it goes in really well. There is surprisingly small amount of force needed to drill, so I think this worked really well. Yeah, it goes in really easily. Yeah, great success. Yeah, we managed to save the drill. Now it's good as new, and before the sharpening it was completely useless. So, especially when we have from 2 millimeters up to like 80 millimeters, like probably hundreds of these drills. So when you have collection of this big, and most of our work is like only one hole, two holes per piece, so it doesn't matter that much that these drills are much slower than the newer, like, tungsten carbide drills. And these are still pretty expensive, especially the larger ones. So I think that's really good machine to have. But on the probably next week we are going to have cleaning up the workshop with Timo video. And I'm quite sure that we will found some interesting old machinery where we are cleaning up. Because the company is over 60 years old and it has been here like 40 years, so there is lot of stuff. But the drill sharpening machine is like my favorite old machine that we have. Yeah, and if you like the shirt, there is link to that in description. But that's all for today.
Thanks for watching.
And have a nice day.
It's a prank!